Hello, assalamu alaikum everyone, welcome to my channel. So today we are starting a new chapter, which is the gastrointestinal tract from drop-ins. So stay with me till the end. Today we are going to cover the congenital abnormalities of the GIT. Before starting it, let's read out this first paragraph. The gastrointestinal tract is a hollow tube extending from the oral cavity to the anus that consists of anatomically distinct segments, including the esophagus, stomach, small intestine, colon, rectum, and anus. So basically, the GIT, which we are saying gastrointestinal tract, is a hollow tube that extends from the oral cavity to the anus. It has different segments. It starts from the oral cavity. So after oral cavity comes the pharynx, then after pharynx comes the esophagus, then stomach, then small intestine and large intestine, and then rectum, and then anus. Okay, each of these segments has unique, complementary, and highly integrated functions, which together serve to regulate the intake, processing, and absorption of ingested nutrients and the disposal of waste products, which we already know. What is the function of GIT? The regional variations in structure and function are reflected in the diseases of the GIT, which often affect one or another segment preferentially. Accordingly, following consideration of several important congenital abnormalities, the discussion is organized anatomically. So, hum log anatomically chalenge. Pehle hum esophagus ki disorders padhenge, then hum log stomach ke, then small intestine ke. इस तरह चलेंगे डिसऑर्डर्स अफेक्टिंग मोर देन वन सेगमेंट. अगर कोई ऐसा डिसऑर्डर है जो एक से ज्यादा सेगमेंट को इन्वॉल्व कर रहा है जीआईटी के, सो फॉर एन एग्जांपल क्रॉन्स डिजीज, तो हम लोग उस डिसऑर्डर को वहां पढ़ेंगे जहां पे वो डिसऑर्डर जिस सेगमेंट को सबसे ज्यादा इन्वॉल्व कर रहा है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल क्रॉन्स डिजीज को हम लोग पढ़ते हैं लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन के अंदर पढ़ रहे होते हैं हम लोग, स्मॉल और लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन में हम इसको पढ़ रहे होते हैं, क्योंकि क्रॉन्स डिजीज इन्फ्लेमेटरी बाउल डिजीज है जिसमें सबसे ज्यादा कौन से सेगमेंट इन्वॉल्व होगा, स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन और कोलॉन ज्यादा इन्वॉल्व होगा, तो हम उसमें पढ़ेंगे इसको इन्फ्लेमेटरी बाउल डिजीज में. ठीक है, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट कंजेनाइटल एबनॉर्मैलिटीज फर्स्ट. डिपेंडिंग ऑन बोथ द नेचर एंड टाइमिंग ऑफ द इंसर्ट ड्यूरिंग गेस्टेशन, अ वैरायटी ऑफ डेवलपमेंटल एनोमलीज कैन इफेक्ट द जीआईटी. Importantly, because many organs develop simultaneously during embryogenesis, the presence of congenital GI disorders should prompt evolution of other organs. Some defects are commonly associated with GI lesions. Okay. It's better. Okay. So let's talk about atresia, fistula, and duplications. Atresia means a complete obstruction of any segment of the GIT. Atresia, fistula, and duplications may occur in any part of the GIT. When present within the esophagus, they are discovered shortly after birth, usually due to regurgitation during feeding. सो एट्रेजिया, फिस्चुला और डुप्लीकेशन जो है वो किसी भी सेगमेंट पे हो सकते हैं जीआईटी के. सबसे पहले एट्रेजिया क्या है, अ कंप्लीट ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन ऑफ एनी पार्ट ऑफ द जीआईटी इज कॉल्ड एट्रेजिया. ओके, ब्लाइंड एंडिंग पाउच. फिस्चुला इज एन एबनॉर्मल कनेक्शन बिटवीन टू सेगमेंट्स ऑफ द जीआईटी. ओके, बिटवीन टू सेगमेंट्स, बिटवीन टू डिफरेंट ऑर्गन्स, सो दिस इज फिस्चुला. एंड देन डुप्लीकेशन मीन्स प्रेजेंस ऑफ, फॉर एग्जाम्पल एन ईसोफेगस शुड बी वन, it is one in our body, so duplication means double. Okay, may occur in any part of the GIT. When atresia, fistula, and duplications are present in the esophagus, they are discovered shortly after birth. Why they are discovered shortly after birth? Because due to the regurgitation during feeding, due to the backup of food through the mouth, okay, without prompt surgical repair, these lesions are incompatible with life. अगर इन लीजन्स को सर्जिकली रिपेयर नहीं किया जाएगा तो दैट विल बी इनकम्पैटिबिलिटी टू लाइफ. अ न्यू बॉर्न कैन नॉट सर्वाइव अगर इनको सर्जिकली रिपेयर ना किया जाए. तो इस वजह से ये हमें फॉरन जस्ट आफ्टर द बर्थ हमें ऐसी चीज़ें नज़र आती हैं, सिम्टम्स नज़र आएंगे, साइंस नज़र आएंगी, जिससे हमें पता चलेगा कि कोई कंजेनाइटल एबनॉर्मेलिटी है और उसको सर्जिकली रिपेयर किया जाए. और अगर सर्जिकली रिपेयर नहीं करा जाएगा देन इट विल बी इनकम्पैटिबल टू लाइफ. What is absence or agenesis? Agenesis means complete absence of anything, any organ, any part of an organ. एब्सेंस और एजेनेसिस ऑफ ईसोफेगस इज एक्सट्रीमली रेयर कंडीशन. ऐसा नहीं होता है, ऐसा बहुत कम होता है कि कंप्लीटली ईसोफेगस एब्सेंट हो, मतलब फेरिंग्स के बाद डायरेक्टली स्टमक को ईसोफेगस हो ही ना. बट एट्रेजिया इन विच डेवलपमेंट एट्रेजिया इन विच डेवलपमेंट इज इनकम्प्लीट इज मोर कॉमन. एट्रेजिया इज मोर कॉमन देन एजेनेसिस. एट्रेजिया मीन्स कंप्लीट ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द ईसोफेगस और एनी सेगमेंट ऑफ द जी आई टी. In esophageal atresia, a thin, non-canalized cord replaces a segment of esophagus, causing a mechanical obstruction. What happens in the esophageal atresia? In esophageal atresia, a thin, non-canalized cord replaces a segment of esophagus, causing a mechanical obstruction. So food cannot pass because of the complete obstruction of the esophagus is called esophageal atresia. Atresia occurs most commonly at or near the tracheal bifurcation and is usually associated with a fistula connecting the upper and lower esophageal pouches to a bronchus or the trachea. So let's see figure 17.1a, A and B. So this is trachea and this is esophagus. Here they are showing esophageal atresia. So yahan aap dekhe, esophagus ek complete tube honi chahiye thi jahan se food pass ho. Lekin in the middle, esophagus is replaced by a fibrous cord. Okay, so how can the food pass from this upper segment to the lower segment of the esophagus? It is not possible. So this is esophageal atresia. Okay, and esophageal atresia is more common at the bifurcation of trachea. It is more common where the trachea bifurcates into right and left bronchus. Okay, in the first diagram, they are showing an isolated esophageal atresia. In the diagram B, they are showing proximal esophageal atresia with the distal tracheoesophageal fistula. And in the third diagram, they are showing H-shaped tracheoesophageal fistula. Okay. The most common type is type B, in which there is a proximal esophageal atresia with the distal tracheoesophageal fistula. Upper segment of the esophagus जो है atretic है और जो lower segment esophagus का है वो connect हुआ है किसके साथ, trachea के साथ, fistula बना हुआ है, abnormal connection between esophagus and trachea. Okay, and this is H-shaped tracheoesophageal fistula. Atresia occurs most commonly at or near the tracheal bifurcation and is usually associated with a fistula connecting the upper and lower esophageal pouches to a bronchus or the trachea. In other cases, a fistula can be present without atresia. Either form of fistula can lead to aspiration, suffocation, pneumonia, and severe fluid and electrolyte imbalances. So, ye jo diagram C hai, it is showing an isolated tracheoesophageal fistula with no atresia. Okay, but the most common type is type B. Moving forward, developmental abnormalities of the esophagus are associated with congenital heart defects, genitourinary malformations, and neurologic diseases. So, esophageal atresia with the tracheoesophageal fistula is associated with other congenital abnormalities, for example, congenital heart disease, genitourinary malformations, and neurologic diseases. And one important point is esophageal atresia with the tracheoesophageal fistula is occurs in women with the polyhydramnios. Okay, intestinal atresia is less common than esophageal atresia but frequently involves the duodenum. In perforate anus, the most common form of congenital intestinal atresia is due to the failure of cloacal diaphragm to involute. Okay, in imperforate anus, the cloacal diaphragm fails to involute, so it lead to imperforate anus and the newborn will not be able to pass the feces, the meconium. Okay, now stenosis. There is a major difference between atresia and stenosis. In atresia, there is a complete obstruction of the esophagus, while in stenosis, there is a narrowing of the lumen. Lumen jitna hona chahiye, usse kam lumen hoga, lekin lumen present hoga stenosis ke andar. Atresia ke andar complete lumen ki absence ho jayegi, jo lumen hoga, wo replaced ho jayega by fibrotic tissue, fibrosis, okay? Stenosis is an incomplete form of atresia, okay, in which the lumen is markedly reduced in caliber as a result of fibrous thickening of the wall. Due to the fibrous thickening of the wall, there is the decrease in the caliber of the lumen that is called stenosis. This results in either partial or complete obstruction. In addition to congenital forms, stenosis can be acquired as a consequence of inflammatory scarring, such as that caused by chronic gastroesophageal reflux, irradiation, systemic sclerosis, or caustic injury. Here we are talking about the congenital stenosis, which is present at the time of birth, but there can be an acquired stenosis, which occurs due to the GERD, irradiation, systemic sclerosis, and caustic injury. Stenosis can involve any part of the GIT, but the esophagus and small intestines are affected most often. Now let's talk about diaphragmatic hernia, omphalocele, and gastroschisis. Diaphragmatic hernia occurs when incomplete formation of the diaphragm allows the abdominal viscera to herniate into the thoracic cavity. Hernia means an abnormal protrusion of any organ outside its normal confines. Jahan wo normally hona chahiye, usse bahar koi cheez aa jaye. Abnormally hamare paas thoracic cavity se pass ho raha hota hai esophagus. Esophagus gastroesophageal junction pe milta hai aur wahan se wo convert ho jata hai kisme? Stomach mein. Okay? Aur esophagus kahan se pass hota hai? Esophagus diaphragm mein diaphragm se pass hota hai. Diaphragm में at the level of T10 esophagus pass करता है और enter होता है stomach में, okay? अगर हमारा stomach जो है वो replace हो जाए और वो abdominal cavity से thoracic cavity में move कर जाए ऊपर की तरफ, that is called hernia. Diaphragmatic hernia occurs when incomplete formation of the diaphragm allows the abdominal viscera जो है to herniate into the thoracic cavity. When severe, the space filling effect of the displaced viscera can cause pulmonary hypoplasia. Because jab the abdominal viscera thoracic cavity mein aayenge, to wo lungs ki jagah ko occupy kar lenge. Jab lungs ki jagah ko occupy karenge, that lead to the pulmonary hypoplasia. Kyunki pulmonary ki complete development, complete growth nahi ho payegi, that lead to pulmonary hypoplasia. That is incompatible with life. Okay. Omphalocele occurs. So let's talk about hernia in a detail first. So diaphragmatic hernia ki do types hoti hai hamare paas. Ek hota hai sliding hernia aur dusra hota hai paraesophageal hernia. Sliding hernia mein ye hota hai ki jo stomach hota hai, sliding hernia ko hum log sliding hernia mein aisa hota hai ki stomach jo hai gastroesophageal junction jo hai wo move karega into the thoracic cavity. Okay? While in paraesophageal hernia, the gastroesophageal junction remains in the abdominal cavity, remains it at their place, but the fundus moves into the fundus or the greater curvature of the stomach moves into the thoracic cavity. Okay, so sliding hernia hai, wo risk increase karega GERD ka, kyunki usme jo gastroesophageal junction hai, wo thoracic cavity mein move kar raha hai. Jab wo upper ki taraf move karega, to GERD के chances ज़्यादा होंगे, gastroesophageal reflux disease के chances ज़्यादा होंगे, और paraesophageal hernia के अंदर कम होंगे. Now let's talk about omphalocele. Omphalocele occurs when closure of the abdominal musculature is incomplete and abdominal viscera herniate into the ventral membranous sac. Okay. This may be repaired surgically, but as many as 40% of infants with an omphalocele have other birth defects. Gastroschisis is similar to omphalocele, except that it involves all the layers of the abdominal wall from the peritoneum to the skin. Okay, there is a major difference between omphalocele and gastroschisis. These both are the anterior abdominal wall defects. Hai ye dono, theek hai? Lekin omphalocele mein aisa hota hai ki jo abdominal contents jo bahar aate hain, body se bahar aa rahe hote hain, wo वो कवर्ड होते हैं एमनियोटिक सैक के अंदर. ओके, व्हाई इन गैस्ट्रोस्काइसिस जो एब्डोमिनल कॉन्टेंट्स बाहर आते हैं एब्डोमिनल कैविटी से वो कवर नहीं होते एमनियोटिक सैक के अंदर. ओके, और ओम्फेलोसील के साथ अदर कंजेनाइटल एनोमलीज भी होती है लाइक ट्राइसोमी 13, ट्राइसोमी आई डोंट रिमेंबर अदर थिंग्स बट ट्राइसोमी 13 और कंजेनाइटल एनोमलीज होती हैं. गैस्ट्रोस्काइसिस के अंदर और कंजेनाइटल एनोमलीज नहीं होंगी साथ में. ठीक है, नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट एक्टोपिया. एक्टोपिक टिश्यूज और डेवलपमेंटल रेस्ट. एक्टोपिया का सिंपल मीनिंग ये होता है कि जो टिश्यू जो है अपनी नॉर्मल जगह से कहीं और जगह पे पाया जाए. फॉर एग्जाम्पल स्टमक का जो म्यूकोजा है वो हमारे पास ईसोफेगस में अगर प्रेजेंट हो दैट मीन्स एक्टोपिक गैस्ट्रिक म्यूकोजा इज प्रेजेंट इन द ईसोफेगस. अगर हमारे पास स्टमक का म्यूकोजा या पेनक्रियाटिक टिश्यू जो है वो प्रेजेंट है हमारे पास ड्यूडिनम के अंदर या इलियम के अंदर तो वो भी एक्टोपिक टिश्यू होगा. ओके, एक्टोपिक टिश्यू मीन्स अ प्रेजेंस ऑफ अ नॉर्मल टिश्यू इन द एबनॉर्मल लोकेशन. ठीक है, एक्टोपिक टिश्यूज डेवलपमेंटल रेस्ट आर कॉमन इन द GIT. द मोस्ट फ्रीक्वेंट साइट ऑफ एक्टोपिक गैस्ट्रिक म्यूकोजा इज द अपर थर्ड ऑफ द ईसोफेगस. एक्टोपिक गैस्ट्रिक म्यूकोजा जो मोस्ट कॉमन साइट है गैस्ट्रिक म्यूकोजा का एक्टोपिकली प्रेजेंट होना वो कहाँ पर है, अपर थर्ड ऑफ द ईसोफेगस में प्रेजेंट होता है. वेयर इट इज रिफर्ड टू एज एन इनलेट पैच वाइल जनरली ए सिम्टोमैटिक एसिड रिलीज बाई गैस्ट्रिक म्यूकोजा विद इन द ईसोफेगस कैन रिजल्ट इन डिस्फेजिया difficulty in swallowing and esophagitis inflammation of the esophagus. Barrett esophagus or rarely adenocarcinoma due to the presence of ectopic gastric mucosa in the esophagus basically in the upper third of the esophagus can be asymptomatic but can cause acid release from the gastric mucosa within the esophagus that can cause jiski wajah se dysphagia ho jayega, inflammation ho jayegi esophagus ki, Barrett esophagus metaplasia ho jayega aur adenocarcinoma bhi ho sakta hai esophagus ka. Okay, jab Barrett esophagus hoga to adenocarcinoma hoga. Ectopic pancreatic tissue occur less frequently and can be found in the esophagus or stomach. Ab pancreatic tissue jo hai wo hamare paas esophagus mein bhi ho sakta hai ya stomach mein bhi ho sakta hai. Like inlet patches these nodules are most often asymptomatic but they produce damage and local inflammation in some cases. When ectopic pancreatic tissue is present in the pylorus, inflammation scarring may lead to obstruction. Agar ectopic pancreatic tissue pylorus mein present hai, jahan se pylorus se duodenum start hota hai, to wahan pe pylorus ki inflammation hogi, scarring hogi aur obstruction ho jayegi pylorus ki. Because the rest may be present within any layer of the gastric wall, they can mimic invasive cancer. हमें ऐसा लग सकता है ectopic rest mucosa में भी हो सकता है GIT के सब mucosa के अंदर या muscularis propria के अंदर किसी भी layer के अंदर हो सकता है तो हमें ऐसा लगेगा ये invasive cancer है but ये invasive cancer नहीं ये ectopic gastric tissue कहीं present है. ठीक है, gastric heterotopia small patches of ectopic gastric mucosa in the small bowel or colon may present with occult blood loss due to peptic ulceration of adjacent mucosa. Okay, so this is all about today's lecture. In the next upcoming lecture, we will do Meckel's diverticulum and we will start from the Meckel's diverticulum.